I can't stomach this kind of thing.
Okay, I like it, but I have no idea what it is. I still like the music. I don't hate it. Do not know who it is yet. Aw, poor baby, got his heart broken.
It just sounds like he's not opening his mouth all the way. I can't stomach this kind of thing.
I'm fine, but it's torture.
I'm not feeling it, man.
This one reminds me of XXXTentacion.
Sounds like suicide if you ever leave me. I think maybe unhealthy.
That's called clone rap. It's like, it sounds like whatever, it's just no.
I like that. Good melody. It sounds like hip hop, but yet mellow.
Maybe I don't understand it.
It's all right. Little piano. Ding. I guess simple is good sometimes.
Is this the same guy? He's a very sad boy.
Well, I don't think XXXTentacion would sing like this.
There's emotion here. There's soul here.
Stop making it hard for him. Get it together.
Are you making it hard for her?
That one was better. It was definitely had a little bit more musicality to it.
All it was is, girl, you're making it hard for me. Do not get in a relationship with this guy.
Tell her feeling like I'm trapped in my damn mind.
Huh?
Like
I'm sorry, what?
Yeah. This is a good song right here.
Wow. This is completely different.
It keeps the same vibe. It's like real mellowish.
This guy's depressed.
He is so sad. That's all he's doing is talking about this person who left him.
That one's okay. It seems like he's sort of feeling himself a little bit now. He's like, you know, you, we broke up, I'm moving on.
That's the first one I like really so far. I could tolerate listening to it the whole way. The other ones were way too simple.
Wow, yeah, this is some cool music. I'm in pain, wanna
put 10 shots in my brain. No, don't do that.
What? 10 shots in my brain?
He needs to talk to Logic about that phone number.
Oh, this is so dreary and droopy.
Yeah, and instead the N-word, I'm out. Again, I'm out.
Great bomb by my uncle playing with a Slipknot. I'm not loving this. I feel like the crotchety old mom who's like, turn that music down.
Wow, that's intense. They're sad.
I like it, but it like, boy, is messed up.
I find it musically repetitive. I find the auto-tune is just so much. It sounds like a mistake.
Do you have any idea who these songs are by?
No, I don't, but he sounds young.
I thought it was Triple X, but I don't know for sure.
XXXTentacion, because I know that he was gonna come up with a new album.
So we'll give you the answer in just a second.
Okay.
But he's been one of the most requested artists for us to cover.
Really?
And the parents have already reacted to him once before.
What? Oh. It's XXXTentacion. I almost said it earlier, but he sounds totally different.
And we're actually going to show you a snippet of that episode now.
Oh, boy, let's do it.
Can't keep my in my pants.
Can't keep his in his pants.
Keep your in your pants.
Can't keep my in my pants.
Ah! Yeah, you go, Faith.
Can't keep my in my pants.
Oh, I remember this.
How old is his child singing this?
He sounds 12. Is he about 12?
Yeah, he does sound young.
The lyrics are constantly talking about drugs.
I put a hole in your parents.
That's terrible!
Right.
Look at me.
Okay, I like it, but I have no idea what I still like the music.
That little bitch got a throat.
My ears. Golly, this guy.
Ooh. So I'd argue that it's much easier to understand what he says in the new songs.
Ooh. Wow, he's so angry.
She's my favorite.
So I feel like he's a feminist then, right?
Ooh, shit. Shit.
It's just whack. He's just trying to get a response.
Still sounds a little angry.
He was angry. Looks like he was angry. Not anymore.
I like the beat. And then until you start listening to the words, and you're like, oh.
Ugh. That is hilarious.
The songs I heard didn't have as much of an edge. My reaction would have been a little different if I had heard about somebody pulling his dick out of his pants.
It's a natural progression in my mind. I mean, to go from being so angry against someone else to suicide and depression and things like that.
At that time, I had no idea who he was. When I went home, I started looking at some of his videos, and I saw why the teenagers freaking like it, because that's not all he does.
So those were all songs by XXXTentacion.
Say that one more time slowly.
I'm glad I had that guy right, you know? Because even though I hadn't listened to his music that just came out this year, I recognize his voice.
We rarely react to things here twice, but the demand for this was so high that we felt like we needed to do it again.
Yeah.
Well, why do you think people ask for the parents to react to him again?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious that most parents would hear that and just want to throw the speaker into the toilet. Kids love getting a rise out of their parents.
To see what we're gonna think, and I think there's gonna be a lot of anticipation that parents are gonna say, no, I don't want my children listening to that.
Initially, it was super angry music, and we were also told about his history, and this is incredibly different music. You know, show some maturity.
I remember when I was growing up, N.W.A. was a no-no to listen to. But, you know, now I feel like that's how sometimes kids relate to the music.
We did not favor him very much the last time. I'm glad y'all, you know what I mean, fought for him to have another chance. He did so much better.
XXXTentacion's career has been largely dominated by several controversies. He's been arrested multiple times, has been in physical altercations with fans, and has had feuds with other artists as well.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it's just, they try to shock the consciousness. It works.
In your experience, when artists behave this way, can people look past the behavior if they enjoy the music, or will people stop listening to an artist even if they like the music when they act this way?
Begrudgingly, I listen to Kanye. And I think his behavior is almost harder to get past.
It's really about the music. A lot of kids don't even listen to the lyrics. It's not about copying what those guys are doing.
If my kids were at home, we're listening to him, I'd want to know more about why. What do you like about this person?
People always want to separate the platform from the person, and I'm always like, the platform is the person. That's just an extension of who you are.
XXXTentacion has also done many things to improve his reputation over the last year. Many fans now watch his YouTube channel, where he posts vlogs and gaming videos in addition to his music. He also posted a video last month called the hashtag The Helping Hand Challenge, where he donated many goods to people in need.
Nice.
Do you think these actions would make him someone you'd want your kids emulating, or do his previous transgressions make him someone you wouldn't want your kids looking up to, regardless of what he's doing now?
No. Look, everybody's got a past. He's making good, right?
I would want them to see a person for all of who they are, and I believe it's possible for people to change.
If I'm not gonna judge myself on who I was 2 years ago or a year ago or a month ago, then it's certainly not fair for me to judge someone who they were.
It's good to see someone, you know, go from, you know, having a lot of transgressions, being, you know, getting in trouble with the law, to someone now that's, you know, giving back, being more mature, trying to, you know, paint a better image of himself.
So finally, last time we did this episode, we ended the episode asking if the parents would be okay with their kids listening to XXXTentacion.
I'm gonna go with the same answer, and I'm not gonna block my kid from listening to something.
Yeah, I would trust that they would make great decisions about which way they want to go.
I'm okay with that. You cannot hide that from your kids.
I actually want them to hear the new stuff because I want them to see the difference.
I would be okay with my kids listening to his music.
I would be okay with it because I know they're gonna listen to the stuff that's positive. I trust what I instilled in my kids.
I'll be okay with my son listening to it and my daughter. Matter of fact, I'm gonna tell him, hey, I listened to it, let's go listen together.
If he were truly and sincerely starting to create a culture or vibe or new music that is reflective of where we'd like to be as a society, I'm all for it. But if you want to listen to that old crap, you better get those headphones on and go move somewhere else.
Thanks for watching this episode of Parents React.
If you want to see more, subscribe.
Shout out to Happy Ghost Bros and Fletcher Ward. What's up?
Let us know in the comments what artists we should react to next.
Hi guys, JC here, producer here at FBE. Thanks so much for watching this episode of Parents React. What other artists do you want the parents to listen to next? Let us know down in the comments. Bye guys.